helps you with anxiety, insomnia, depression, ADD, ADHD, PTSD, or dyslexia, and more, just like it does for me. Well, then I hope this is the video that you're looking for. If so, don't forget to like and subscribe, and comment on what I should read next, since I upload a new video and read a new book every day. Part 2 will be uploaded soon, or the full version is already on ASMRflix.com, depending on when or where you're watching this. Also, don't forget, if you're using this video to sleep, you can go to ASMRflix.com/fadeout and copy and paste this URL on it so it'll fade out as you fall asleep. Today, we are reading the Constitution and the Declaration of Independence. I can't wait. Let's begin. The preamble. Actually, I think I could do this. I memorized it a long time ago. We the people, in order to form a more perfect union, establish justice, secure domestic tranquility, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, secure the blessing of liberty, to ourselves and our prosperity, to ordain and establish this Constitution for the United States of America. You guys can tell me if I did it right. It's been a while. Thank you, Schoolhouse Rock. Article 1, Section 1. All legislative powers herein granted shall be vested in a Congress of the United States, and shall consist of the Senate and the House of Representatives. Section 2. The House of Representatives shall be composed of the members chosen every second year by the people of the several states, and the electors in each state shall have the qualifications requested for the electors of the most numerous branch of the state legislature. No person shall be a representative who shall not have attained to the age of 25 years and have been seen 7 years a citizen of the United States, and who shall not, when elected, be an initiate of the state in which he shall be chosen. Representatives and direct taxes shall be appropriated among the several states which may be included within this union according to their respective numbers, which shall be determined by adding to the whole number of free persons, including the bound of serve for a term of years, and excluding Indians not taxed, 3/5 of all other persons. The actual enumeration shall be made within 3 years after the first meeting of Congress of the United States, and within every subsequent term of 10 years, in such manner as that thou shalt be law direct. The number of representatives shall not exceed 1/4 every 30,000, but each state shall have at least one representative, and until such enumeration shall be made, the state of New Hampshire shall be entitled to choose 3, Massachusetts 8, Rhode Island in the province plantations 1, Connecticut 5, New York 6, New Jersey 4, Pennsylvania 8, Delaware 1, chosen by the legislature. They're off for 6 years, and each senator shall have one vote. Immediately after, they shall be assembled in a consequence of the first election. They shall be divided as equally as may be into three classes. The seats of the senators of the first class shall be vacated at the expiration of the second year, of the second class at the expiration of the fourth year, and of the third class at the expiration of the sixth year, so that one third may be chosen every second year. And if vacancies happen by resignation or otherwise during the recess of legislature of any state, the executive thereof may make temporary appointments until the next meeting of the legislature, which shall then fill such vacancies. No person shall be a senator who shall not have attained to the age of 30 years and have been 9 years a citizen of the United States, and who shall not, when elected, be an inhabitant of the United States, of the state for which he shall be chosen. The Vice President of the United States shall be the President of the Senate, but shall have no vote unless they be equally divided. The Senate shall choose their officers, and also a president pro tempore, in the absence of the vice president, or when he shall exercise the office of the president of the United States. The Senate shall have the sole power to try all impeachments. When sitting for the purpose, they shall be on oath or affirmation. When the President of the United States is tired, the Chief Justice shall preside, and no person shall be convinced without the concurrence of 2/3 of members present. Judgment in cases of impeachment shall not extend further than to removal from office and disqualification to hold and enjoy any office of tenure, trust, or profit under the United States. But the party convention shall nevertheless be liable and subject to indictment, trial, judgment, and punishment according to law. Section 4. The times, places, and manner of holding elections for senators and representatives shall be prescribed in each state by the legislature thereof, but the Congress may at any time by law make or alter such regulations, except as to the place of choosing senators. The Congress shall assemble at least once in every year, and such meetings shall be on the first Monday in December, unless they shall by law appoint a different day. Section 5. Each house shall be the judge of the elections, returns, and qualifications of its own as each house may provide. Each house may determine the rules of its proceedings, punish its members for disorderly behavior, and with the concurrence of 2/3 expel a member. Each house shall keep a journal of its proceedings from the time to time publish of the same, expecting such a part as may in the judgment require sorcery and the yes and nays of the members of either house on any question shall at the desire of 1/5 of those present be entered on the journal. Neither house during the session of Congress shall without the consent of the other adjourn for more than 3 days, nor to any other place than that in which the two houses shall be sitting. Section 6. The senators and representatives shall receive a compensation for their services, to be ascertained by law and paid out of the Treasury of the United States. They shall in all cases except treason, felony, and breach of the peace be privileged from arrest during their attendance at the session of their House respective houses, and in going to and returning from the same, and for any speech or debate in either house, they shall not be questioned in any other place. No senator or representative shall be during the time of which he was elected be appointed to any civil office under the authority of the United States, which shall have been created, or the emoluments whereof shall have been increased during such time, and no person holding any office under the United States shall be a member of either house during his constituents in office. Section 7. A bill for raising revenue shall originate in the House of Representatives, but the Senate may propose or concur with amendments as on any other bills. Every bill shall have passed the House of Representatives, and the Senate shall, before it become a law, be presented to the President of the United States. If he approves, he shall sign it, but if not, shall return it with his objections to the House in which it shall originate, who shall enter the objections at large on their journal, and proceed to reconsider it. If after such reconsideration 2/3 of that House shall agree to pass the bill, it shall be sent together with the objections to the other House, by which shall likewise be reconsidered, and if approved by 2/3 of that House, it shall become law or a law. But in all such cases, the votes of both houses shall be determined by yeas and nays, and the names of the persons voting for and against the bill shall be entered on the journal of each house respectively. If any bill shall not be returned by the President Sundays accepted after it shall be been presented to him. The same shall be a law in like manner as if he has signed it, unless the Congress by which their adjournment prevent its return, in which case it shall be a law. Every order, resolution, or vote to which the concurrence of the Senate and the House of Representatives may be necessary, except on a question of adjournment, shall be presented to the President of the United States, and before the same shall take effect, shall be approved by or being disapproved by him, shall be repassed by 2/3 of the Senate and House of Representatives, according to the rules and limitations prescribed in the case of a bill. Section 8. The Congress shall have power to lay and collect taxes, duties, imposts, and exercise an excess to pay the debts and provide for the common defense and general welfare of the United States. But all duties, imposts, and exercise shall be uniform throughout the United States. To borrow money on the credit of the United States. To regulate, commence, nations and among several states and with Indian tribes. To establish an uniform rule of naturalization and uniform laws on the subject of bankruptcies throughout the United States. Securing for limited time to authors and investors with exclusive rights to the respective writings and discoveries, to constitute tribunals inferior to the Supreme Court, to define and punish piracies and felonies committed on the high seas and offenses against the law of nations, to declare war, grant letters of marque and reprisal, and make rules concerning captures on the land and water, to raise and support armies, but no appropriation of money to the use shall be for a longer term than 2 years. To provide and maintain a navy, to make guide for organizing, arming, and disciplining the militia, and for governing such part of them as may be employed in the service of the United States, reserving to the states of respectively the appointed of the officers and the authority of training the militia according to discipline prescribed by Congress, to exercise exclusive legislation in all cases whatsoever over such district not exceeding 10 miles square, as may by cession of particular states and the acceptance of Congress become the state of government in the United States, and to exercise like authority over all places purchased by the consent of the legislature of the state in which the same shall be, for the erection of forts, magazines, arsenals, dockyards, and other needful buildings, and to make all laws which shall be necessary and proper for carrying unto execution in foreign powers and all other powers vested by this Constitution in government of the United States or any department or officer therefore. Section 9. Such importation not exceeding $10 for each person. The privilege of the writ of habeas corpus shall not be suspended unless when in cases of rebellion or invasion the public safety may require it. No bill or attainder or ex post facto law shall be passed. No caption or other direct tax shall be laid unless in proposition to the census of the enumeration hereon therefore direct be taken. No tax or duty shall be laid on articles exported from any state. No preference shall be given by any regulation of commerce or revenue to the ports of one state over those of another. No shall vessel bound to or from one state be obliged to enter, clear, or pay duties in another. No money shall be drawn from the treasury, but in consequence of appropriations made by law and regular statement and account of the receipts and expenditures of all public money shall be published from time to time. No title of nobility shall be granted by the United States, and no person holding any office of profit or trust under them shall, without the consent of the Congress, except of any present employment, office, or title of any kind whatever from any king, prince, section 10 will be in part 2. I'm not sure when I will upload part 2. Maybe 12 views from now, maybe 100, a million, a trillion, who knows. But one day, or if not already, is the full version at ASMRflix.com. I hope this video helped you.